same time.
Mastodon!
Pterodactyl!
Triceratops!
Saber-tooth tiger!
Tyrannosaurus!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 32 of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, a.k.a. OrangeRanger198 on the Twitters. And once again, we are returning to the early 90s to watch two more episodes of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, Something Fishy, and Lions and Blizzards. But first, we do have a little bit of news.
Cue music.
Cue Becky.
Good evening.
First off, if you happen to be going around Twitter or anywhere else, a bunch of the tributes have started coming in for Pua Magusiva, who played Shane the Red Wind Ranger on Ninja Storm after he passed away last week. Lots of former Rangers, from castmates to just other Rangers, plus other actors that were with him on other shows out in New Zealand, have been paying tribute over the past week. There's also been a petition put forth to get Hasbro to add the Red Wind Ranger to the Lightning Collection sooner rather than later. I don't know if that's going to work. I would imagine they've already got some plans in that, and that it would take quite a while for them, if they don't already have the Red Wind Ninja Ranger set up, that it would take a while to get that designed and set up and get his face, and I don't know. But in any event, that's all working on right. That's all going on right now. Also, speaking of Power Rangers, because that's what this show does, that hashtag show is reporting more about the mysterious team up we have coming up. At this point, what we know is Austin St. John is going to be going out to New Zealand. We've also got reports of former Dino Charge actors out there already. And, of course, you know, the Beast Morpher crew was there. However, we are now getting reports that the Dino Thunder cast will not be returning for the team-up, despite the fact that it was looking like we were going to get the big Dino team-up. We apparently aren't. Who knows what they're doing at this point? I have no idea, but we're going to find out. Again, this is rumor, but it's looking very good that it's true. So it's a disappointment, because Dino Thunder was actually one of my favorites of the more recent eras, and it's kind of sad that none of them are coming back for this team up, but you do what you can, I guess. In any event, that's it for the news. So what we're going to do is we'll take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll watch Something Fishy.
Today on Power Rangers, a nice picnic and an afternoon of scuba diving turn fishy when Rita sends down the treacherous Goofish.
I am the Goofish. You are no match for me.
Rita then puts a spell on Billy that plays on his worst fears.
Keep it away!
Can the Rangers overcome the Goofish and his venomous spray? Find out next on the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
All right, it's time to watch Something Fishy. So let's get things started in 3, 2, 1, go. Something Fishy is the 43rd episode of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. It first aired on February 9th, 1994, written by Cheryl Saban and directed by Robert Hughes. And according to Sir Isaac's morphology, or Sir Stack's morphology, this is the first episode to include Zoo 2 footage.
Okay, later.
I can't wait to go scuba diving.
Oh, where do you guys see the reef that I found? You're not gonna believe it. It's awesome.
I bet we'll see some really big fish down there.
You know, I have to laugh at the coincidences that come up constantly on this show. Like the fact that just when the ranger teens are ready to go fishing and scuba diving, suddenly for some reason out of the blue, Bulk and Skull decide they're gonna go too.
Gross, Bulk, that's disgusting.
What do you mean? That's perfectly good bait.
Yeah. It'll make us irresistible with the fish. Dislike with the ladies. Right, Trini?
Get a life, Skull.
What are you yapping about?
You really are supposed to keep the worms cold, I thought.
Be caught. Let's go fish.
Wonder if they got a license for the fishing. Wonder if they have to get a license for the fishing.
I don't think the fish need to be too worried about those two.
Hey, Billy, why don't you come with us? You know I'm a certified diving instructor.
My apologies, Jason, but I have a regrettable dislike for fish.
Oh, well, how about you then, Kimberly?
No, there's no reason to spoil a perfectly good hair day. Besides, Billy and I are going to go to the park for a picnic.
A carefully planned distance from any fish substance, I might add.
This is the perfect time to bring out your toxic goo fish or evilness and destroy them all!
Leonard, what are you waiting for? Get to it, Goldar!
Okay, you guys, well, once again, we're at an actual beach.
Final equipment check. All right?
Yeah, because like you always say, safety first, right, man?
Right, bro.
I just can't wait to get down there. With all the fish and plant life, it's going to be beautiful.
Yeah, but first make sure your valves, gauges, and regulators are clear and working right, and that your other equipment fits properly. Okay, everyone ready? Okay.
Okay, this is the first of many times that they go scuba diving.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
This footage of them going scuba diving is an explanation to explain why they aren't around after the actors had left the show for a little bit.
So, what's for lunch anyway?
Fish and chips. Is that okay with you?
I'll just take the chips. Hold the fish. Sorry.
What is with you and fish anyway, Billy?
I've just had some rather humiliating experiences.
That's kind of a rude friend to do that.
It all started when I was little.
You know Billy doesn't like fish. Let's have fish and chips for lunch.
I attempted to recreate what I had recently learned about whirlpools. But my moving finger proved to be an exciting enticement to one of the fish below.
Oh, really?
The fish actually bit me.
That is hilarious.
Don't laugh. It's not funny.
Oh, come on, Billy. At least it wasn't a piranha.
Consequently, it's difficult for me to be near anything fishy.
Well,
looks like she's got sandwiches.
Not bite you.
I don't know. One can never be too careful.
There's not even any chips there.
The others are doing.
Looked like
maybe
lettuce on the plate next to the sandwich.
Negative for me. I'm much happier on dry land. What was that?
I don't know.
I think it's obvious what that is.
I wonder how they knew you'd be fishing today.
Oh yeah, some fishermen you guys are.
Yeah! Just check out all the cool stuff we caught.
Climb it up, sardine head.
Skull's using a fish as an earring.
Well, at least they're cleaning up the environment.
This is it! I knew it!
Yeah, never saw that coming, right?
Come on.
Lights down! Tuna breath. Scared off all the fish.
Yeah, that's what did it.
Let's surprise the scuba divers. Maybe they need some help with their gear.
Okay. Just as long as I don't have to go in.
Deal. Then we can all grab an ice cream afterwards.
Chocolate chip?
Okay.
We have got to keep those two off the beach.
Man, Billy is really pushing the whole keep me away from the fish.
You know, I was about to say the same thing.
Sheesh.
Shut up, you two. We're going fishing for rangers.
I'll get the blanket.
I guess I'll pack up the food then. Oh no, we've got company!
We've seen that pointless footage of the, Billy! Anyway, we've seen that pointless footage of the putty flying in from the air and making a punch, and then not hitting anybody before. Let me guess, they're underwater so they can't hear the beep 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 beep.
I've got it.
Could just run over. Okay. Billy's outfit is rather interesting. He's technically wearing shorts, but a long sleeve shirt. Almost looks like a sweatshirt.
Oh, thank goodness.
Our sensors have detected a disturbance in the ocean near Angel Grove Beach.
Oh no. Zordon, Zach, Jason, and Trini are down there scuba diving.
I am aware of the situation, Kimberly. Rita has unleashed the terror.
Duh, Kimberly, I keep track on all of you all the time. Hello.
It can immobilize anyone or anything it touches.
Look at the mess it's making.
There is no time to wait for the others. You two must deal with the goofish before it's too late.
You know, it sounds like the goofish is actually voiced by Robert Axelrod. Which two are holding hands? I bet you that's Zach and Jason. Poor Trini left up near the top.
Perhaps you should cast a spell to make Billy's fear unbearable.
Okay. Oh, she do to terror. Bring Billy overwhelming terror. Make his fear sharp like a spear. When a fishy sight, fill him with fright. Ay, 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 ay. Something's wrong with Billy.
Rita has cast a spell upon him. He cannot control his fear.
No! Keep him away!
Billy,
keep him away, Kim!
What's
no.
the matter?
That's right! Be afraid, for soon you will suffer my wrath!
Billy!
Keep it away! No!
Okay.
Man, it was so clear down there.
Totally.
Yeah.
You puppies!
Zordon, we need help!
That was an awesome dive.
Totally amazing, man.
I can't believe how beautiful it is down there.
Rangers, come in.
You guys, we've got trouble. What is it, Zordon?
Rita has trapped the other rangers with a venomous goofish. You must help them immediately.
We're on our way. Come on, guys. It's morphin' time!
They're wearing scuba gear. You think the morphers are somewhere in there?
Another time, Rangers!
I guess there's a chance. But...
Hey, Bill, are you okay?
Yeah, I
what
think
happened?
So.
What
was that? So, Goldar, what's up next for our goofishy?
I've ordered him to draw out the Megazord and then use his goof to destroy it.
Oh, they forgot the sound effect.
Zordon, we had a lot of trouble with that goofish.
Yeah, man.
No, you didn't. You shot him and he left.
It's all my fault.
You shot him and he left. There was no trouble.
Oh, poor Billy.
Come on, Billy. Don't blame yourself. Everyone has something they're afraid of.
Isn't there anything that we can do to help him, Zordon?
Yeah, we're really gonna need him.
Billy, Rita has cast a spell on you by using your fear of fish. If you face your fear and overcome it, her spell will be broken.
Oh yeah, that's
Zordon,
simple.
I don't think I can face that sea monster.
You have no choice, Billy. Behold the viewing globe. As you can see, the goofish is carving out a terrible path of destruction. Its toxic venom will immobilize anything it touches, humans and sea life alike.
Looks like it got it all over him.
Billy, the other rangers need you.
Billy, are you sure you're ready for this? Billy, we're gonna need you.
I'll try not to let you down.
Alright.
It's morphin' time! There he is, guys. Ready?
You guys go after the goofish. Billy and I will take care of the putties.
Right.
Smart. Let Billy take care of the putties. Like it. Okay, they're starting to reuse some of the footage.
Now, Blue Ranger, the weak link of your pathetic team, your time has come.
Get away! Get back! No! No! Go!
Don't worry, I'm coming!
Oh, for all the good it did.
Are you alright? Let go!
It's not touching them. Oh, there you go. She didn't shoot that, she threw it. That was horrible. Oh, she's been hit by starfish that blew up.
I'm not done, Power Rangers. Take that.
And now leaves and fish. Oh, that sword. The power sword usually is made of something that's pretty strong and not flimsy, but right now it keeps folding while Red Ranger keeps leaning on it. Ooh! He's so fast! Oh yeah, see, that's the footage they just used! Interesting.
Blue Ranger is back.
You get him, Billy.
Way to go, Billy. Thanks. Let's finish this guy off.
It's not over yet. Magic wand. Make my monster.
This must be the part where the monster is going to draw out the Megazord. Kind of interesting. Billy seems to be even more pumped up now.
Do it.
I wonder if they'll show him eating fish later.
Here it comes.
I like the music here. It's the song Fight, but without the words. They're good at blocking the stick for the most part. Oh! And breaking it. Uh-oh.
This goon is jamming the servo! We can't move!
Jason seems excited too. Are they going to call the Dragonzord? Or do you think they'll just figure it out, how to get out of it? Oh, no, the blasts are knocking them down. Also, that was Dragonzord in battle mode cockpit footage.
Man, I don't believe it. We're losing to an overgrown Harry. If only we could get more power. Wait a minute. That's it. What? What are you talking about? Convert working power and convert the goo to energy. Do it!
When did he become so smart?
Right, it's working!
Now, it appears that all of the cockpit footage is from the original Z-Ranger stuff, so there's going to be a lot of reuse here. Which is okay, because we've already had a lot of reuse. Overhead slash!
Proud of you, Billy. You conquered your fear.
I guess I did, didn't I?
I can't believe we lost! I can't take it anymore! That's it! I've had it!
Till next time!
Hey, everyone! Look what I caught!
Wow, Billy, I'm very impressed!
A bag!
You have really overcome.
You caught a whole bag!
Fish. I'm very proud of you.
Maybe you'll come scuba diving with us next time. I'd like that, Jason. I think I could really learn to enjoy that sport.
I'll tell you, he was great. I'm going to cook up the catch in a few minutes, and it's on the house.
Ooh, yummy bag. Roasted bag.
It's starting to smell really fishy around here.
Yeah, because I caught the king of the sea.
What did you catch, Bulk?
Probably a cove.
I caught the big one. Something none of you nerds could ever do. Show him skull.
Right.
Yeah, right, Bulk.
I thought I told you to buy a big fish, Sardine Breath.
I did. It's the only kind of fish I know.
What are you laughing at? Let me see what you caught.
Bulk, I'd be careful. There's a life there.
Of course there is. Well, what did y'all think of that one? That wasn't so bad. Other than the saying they had a lot of trouble with the goofish guy and when it was only like a 5-second fight, I thought that was a pretty good one. The combination of the Zoo 2 footage with the original Zoo Ranger footage was seamless. You really couldn't tell where it switched. Anyway. All right, well, we're going to take a quick break, and then we'll be back with our next episode, Lions and Blizzards.
Today on Power Rangers, the Rangers and their friends win the grand prize at the annual Oddball Game.
Stupendous! We won the Noble Lion Trophy!
Jabberwabba!
A Lion Trophy! I'll show them a Lion Trophy!
Rita and Goldar plot to transform the trophy into a ferocious monster. Can the Rangers withstand this weather-controlling lamb in lion's clothing? Find out next on the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers!
All right, it's time for some Lions and Blizzards, so let's get things started. DVD's all set up, and I'm going to hit start in 3, 2, 1, go. Lions and Blizzards is the 44th episode of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. It first aired on February 10th, 1994, written by Shel Danielson and directed by Robert Hughes. Much competition here. Ew, mouthful of grass. That's disgusting.
What's wrong, Anne? You can't keep up? Come on, hop to it. Hop to it.
Oh, that was pretty good there, Bolt, Skull. Go red team!
Alright, settle down! The red team wins! Good! But there's a tie between the red and the blue team in terms of points. Now, final event, the tug of war. Winning team will receive the coveted Noble Lion Trophy.
And now I think we know what's going to become a monster. Or is the inspiration behind the monster, maybe?
Jason, give it your best shot, Bulk.
Hey, Angela, you want to defect over to the winning side? The Zagman saved a special place just for you.
Dream on!
Yeah, right, Zagman. Angela knows which side the real men are on. Yeah, the real men.
Well, let's not get carried away.
So, a lion trophy, I'll show him a lion trophy.
Of course, my queen. Go Gon the Stormbringer, the Earth and those Power Rangers will be destroyed for good!
On the count of three, I'll blow the whistle. All right, let's do it, Jace.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Now this is how you honestly know that the Power Ranger universe that this show is based on is not based in the same universe as the movies. Because this would be very unfair if it was.
That trophy's mine, Buzzard Brett! Prepare to eat mud!
Prepare to eat your words, Bulk!
Put an end to this!
No!
Time to teach us to the law of physics!
Alright, keep working your mind on together! Now!
Ew. I think that was real mud or mashed potatoes. Ooh, Angela got a two. Gonna pull him into it, isn't she? Oh, no? Okay.
Did you see Bulk's face when he hit the mud?
How about poor Mr. Kaplan?
Well, once again, teamwork has proven most effective against our adversaries.
Hey, Ernie's gonna get a big kick out of the Noble Lion Trophy.
Hey, you guys, speaking of the trophy.
The trophy's gone.
Oh, man, I bet Bulk and Skull has something to do with this.
Come on, we cannot let them get away with it.
Well, this is a decidedly large expanse to cover.
Let's split up.
Okay, I'll go with you, Jace. Come on.
Those goody-goody think they're so smart,
but not meanwhile, smart enough to keep the prize.
They did have something to do with it.
Our trophy's getting away.
Such evil Duke batters.
I'll send down a horde of buddies to keep those power pets away.
Again. Because it works every other time.
Where would you go?
Ugh, don't even mention such a horror.
Ooh, we didn't even get a reaction time. Well, the back one missed. I have to say it, the fights are even better when they have the rock music and the singing. It's okay, he can fight. He did it last time. Okay. Yeah, sometimes it's funny. Sack's pretty good.
Man, that was weird. I wonder what Reed is up to now.
We should go find Kimberly and Jason. Come on.
It's not working.
What is your badness up to?
Silence, you fool! You'll break your concentration!
She's casting a spell!
Yes!
To turn your lion trophy into the dread monster Goten!
Scabs, weasels, moons of Kryon, make me a monster! Half goat, half lion!
It's too bad she doesn't have powers like Lil Zed and could just zap it. Ooh, that's pretty cool. Oh, now the mud comes off. Ew, it is a lion and a goat. Weird.
Too bad about the trophy.
Hey, we don't need a trophy to know that we're winners.
Yeah.
Hey, don't look now, but your dream diva is headed our way.
Ooh.
Can I ask her out again, Zach?
She's a Babasaurus, but, I gave up on Angela a long time ago.
Like, 5 minutes ago?
Gave up, huh?
Hey, Zach. How about you and me catching a matinee or something?
Wait, what? What's happening here?
Don't call me. I'll call you.
Way to go, Zach man.
What?
What is it, Alpha?
Everything suddenly gone haywire.
This disturbance is familiar. I believe Rita has summoned forth her lion goat to attack Angel Grove. Summon the Power Rangers, for Goten the lion goat brings with it terrible storms.
Ay, 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 ay.
If Goten is allowed to control the weather, the entire Earth will be in peril.
weather is particularly precarious.
The storm is just raging outside. It came out from nowhere.
We're in a tornado watch.
Check out Trini's hat.
Guys, I don't like the looks of this.
Something tells me this isn't Mother Nature at work.
Sounds like Rita, if you ask me.
Not often they get to do this right in the middle of the juice bar.
You must teleport to the command center at once.
Zack's not with us.
Alpha will contact it from here. Hurry, Rangers.
All right, guys. Ready for teleportation.
Rangers, we have a dire situation on our hands. Rita has used your noble lion trophy to summon evil Gotan, the Lion Goat.
So that's what happened to the trophy.
Jason's got some weird looking shoes on, too.
Man,
the head of a lion, the tummy of a goat.
Gotan has the
well, with a goat face.
Lizards, tornadoes, anyway. And even hurricanes to destroy the world. This creature must be stopped quickly.
Alpha, have you managed to contact Zack yet?
No luck yet. I can't understand why he's not responding. I'll try
I can.
Chilly in here. Feels like winter.
It'll be dangerous.
It's not that cold.
What are you waiting for? Are we going or
okay.
not?
Okay.
All right. But put your coat on.
It's cold. Alpha will continue trying to raise Zack. You four must go ahead and battle Gotan. Good luck, Rangers.
All right.
It's morphin' time.
Triceratops!
Saber-tooth tiger! Tyrannosaurus! Ah, lunch! Alright, enough is enough!
Can't wait to find out why she wanted to go with Zack to the movie. Oh, he's got his own bow and arrow set! Ooh, that was pretty tough. Well, that was pretty good blast there. Oh, and they just got knocked to the beach. Tornado. A red superimposed tornado.
We can save you now, Power Rangers.
The Rangers are gone forever.
Two heads are better than one.
At last, the end of the Power Rangers is at hand.
They can't count, apparently.
I can't let you. If you try, I'll... I asked you, but you wouldn't listen.
What's that?
Nothing.
Just an alarm?
It was my popcorn alarm. Save my seat. I'll be right back.
Hello, City Desk. I'd like to report a crime. Well, what if I told you it involved a certain young starlet?
Doesn't that kind of look like the hallway at the juice bar?
I'll read you. What's up?
Zack, the Rangers need your help. They've been trapped inside a tornado by Gotan, Rita's evil chimera monster.
I'm on the job. Man, this chimera monster's gonna pay. It's morphin' time.
Mastodon!
Oh, man! Hey, Furball!
So, Black Ranger, you're here!
Man, you are one messed up looking cat.
It's Zack! Just in time!
Oh, you're gonna pay big time! For messing with my friends, and especially for messing up my date.
You're all top, Ranger.
And you're all through. That ought to change your minds, Gotan.
He reacted backwards from the hit. Weird.
Why is it suddenly snowing? Oh, the blizzard effect, right? What's wrong with Zack's glove? It looked like his hand was hurt, or it was like a bandage or something. Pretty cool special effect. The snow doesn't look too fake over the footage. Is terrible. Motor controls are frozen. Glad to see you cooled off, Rangers. Now for the icing on the cake.
Yeah. I still want the left tread. Maybe we can spin this baby.
Yes, apparently spinning yourself to the left a lot will cause the ice to melt. I learned that from Power Rangers. Jeez. Zack really wants to get out of there. He's calling all the shots. It was easy enough.
Congratulations on a job well done, Rangers. I regret your trophy was destroyed.
That's all right. We don't need a trophy to prove that we're winners. Right, Jason?
Right, bro.
Another happy ending.
Oh, no.
Zack, what's wrong?
Speaking of happy endings, I left Angela sitting back at the theater. If I don't get back before the curtain goes down, it's gonna be curtains for me. I'm out of here. See ya.
Oh, poor Zack. Hope it works out.
Charles, I'm so glad you didn't give up. You saved me, you know.
Yeah, well, just lucky, I guess. What are you going to do now?
I thought I'd take a nice long cruise to someplace quiet.
That's great.
Sorry. There's a long line.
Want some company?
Well, she's ticked. Damn. You can't mix superheroics and love life.
Excuse me. I'm trying to find out if anybody can positively identify these two gentlemen.
Identify them? Sure. Aren't they the swamp creatures from the Black Lagoon?
Such a funny joke.
Don't you recognize us? It's us, your friends. Vulcan Skull?
Unfortunately, officer, we do know them.
That's more like it.
Hey, turn on. Hey, I feel something.
Ernie's about to lose his ladder. Oh, nope.
That's okay. We needed a bath anyway.
You know, for it being the first story by this Shel Danielson, it was a good one. Did a good job of mixing it. I still would like to know why Angela all of a sudden decided she wanted to date Zack. Just because he won the competition or something? Makes no sense. Anyway, well, I hope you all have a great week, and I will see you next time for two more episodes of Power Rangers. Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com. or feel free to leave a comment at the show's posting at PowerRangerChronicles.com. All images and music heard on the show are copyright their respective holders and are meant to help celebrate the Power Rangers. No infringement is intended. Power Rangers is copyright Hasbro Entertainment. This show is dedicated to all the men and women both in front of the camera and behind the scenes who have worked to bring us Power Rangers for over 25 years. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thanks again for listening, and good night.